Hello everyone. Today I'd like to walk you through how to unlock the characters for Super Smash Bros. Brawl on the Nintendo Wii, but using a save file that we find online instead of playing through the campaign and unlocking the characters that way. You do need to have a modified Nintendo Wii for this to work, so I've left a link to a tutorial that I find to be quite good in the description. Even though this tutorial is a few years old, I still find it to be current. I just used it last month to modify a couple of Wiis and it's still good. So I'll assume that you've got your Wii modified already. Now we're going to need a tool called SaveGame Manager GX. And there's a few places where we can get this tool and there's a few versions out there. So I'm going to walk through three different options that we have and I'll show you which one I prefer. And then after that we're going to get the save file itself that we need. And we'll get a couple channel forwarders for both SaveGame Manager GX and Wii Mod Lite, and we'll also need Wii Mod Lite to install those forwarders. That part you can skip, especially if you've done it already, but I just like to show it because, you know, if you've freshly modified your Wii, then I think this helps understand like how some of these tools work. So if you've got a lot of these tools installed already, then I invite you to skip ahead. But otherwise, we're gonna start from the beginning, from the point after which you've modified the Wii. So let's go into the Homebrew channel. And then we'll go into the Homebrew browser. So now that we're in the Homebrew browser, let's go to Utilities and scroll way down until we find Save Game Manager GX. So revision 76 is the one I'm using here. Download that and it's done. So I'll press the home button, return to loader. And now you see that I've got it installed. Right, so we're over at the PC, and now I want to get hold of Save Game Manager GX somewhere on the internet, right? I've got my downloads folder open, and that's where the downloaded files will appear. And I've left a link in the description to this webrew.org page, and this is where we're going to download Save Game Manager GX, but the situation is quite messy at time of recording. So if I click on this download link here, it downloads Save Game Manager GX beta. I'll go back into my downloads folder and look at it. Use 7-zip to extract it. If I go in here and look at the meta.xml file, you see that this is version revision 76, just like we saw on the Homebrew browser. Right, so that's fine. It does say beta here, which can be a little bit confusing. So I'll delete this zip file. Now, if I go back to that website, you see there's another link below that download link called website. So let's open that. So now we come to a SourceForge page. So when I go to click this download button, I might think that I'm gonna get Save Game Manager GX, but if you hover over the button, it says download vWii official channel and some other information, right? So let's click that button. Okay, now let's see what we got. vWii official channel 17 blocks forwarder, right? So this is a channel forwarder for the virtual Wii on the Wii U console. Definitely not Save Game Manager GX and not for even the correct console, right? We're using the Nintendo Wii, not the Wii U. So I'll go ahead and delete this because that's definitely not what I'm after. Now back at the SourceForge page, if I want anything, I could go to files. And we see there's a list of different files here. And if you wanted a different revision, the one you would be after is HBC setup R127.zip. If I go ahead and extract these files, and look at the meta.xml file, you see it says revision 127. So the question is, which one should we use? Well, on GBA temp, there's a full thread discussing Save Game Manager GX, and the person who actually wrote the app says, hello, beta R76 has more features and is more stable than R127. So I'll take that person's word for it and just use R76. Go ahead and delete this stuff. So now with my SD card inserted, I'll open the apps folder there and then in my downloads folder, I'll go into SaveGame Manager GX and just copy this folder into the apps folder. And that's done. Now, if you skipped ahead to this part of the video because you just want to see how to get Smash Brothers Brawl 100% unlocked on your modded Nintendo Wii, here's what my SD card looks like currently under apps. I do have SaveGame Manager GX. That's earlier in the video if you want to find out where to get that. And I'll need the save file itself, so go online here. The link in the description shows you where you can find a couple of 100% completed save files, so make sure that you've got your region correct. The backup copy that you are going to use is either NTSC or PAL region. So for me, I've got a backup of the NTSC version. I'll go ahead and download that. And also while we're at it, I'm going to get a channel forwarder for Save Game Manager. I did end up finding one that I liked. So there's a link for that in the description. It's a German website that keeps a database of various things related to the Wii. Go ahead and hit download here. And finally, in order to install the channel forwarder, I need Wii Mod Lite. So I'll get this zip file. And we'll also take the forwarders, why not? All right, so let's look in our downloads folder. So we've got Save Game Manager GX forwarder, Wii Mod Lite, and Wii Mod Lite forwarders. Don't worry about these other files here, nothing to see here. I'll go ahead and using 7-zip, extract to star backslash. Okay, Save Game Manager GX forwarder. Now you see here there are two files. One says Dunkel, which is German for dark, and the other one is the light theme, so you pick the theme that you want. That's fine, I want the light theme. So I will hit Control X, go back over to the SD card. Now I don't have a folder called WADS yet, so I'll make one, Control Shift N, WAD, enter, enter, Control V to paste. That's done, go back to the downloads folder. Under Wii Mod Lite version 7 in the apps folder there, I'll copy this folder, go back to the SD card under apps on the SD card, paste, right? That's Wii Mod Lite installed. One last time to the downloads folder under Wii Mod Lite forwarders. I'll go into the WAD folder and be careful here. There are two options. One says vWii and the other one says Wii. The vWii one is for the virtual Wii on the Wii U. Don't take that one. We want the normal Wii. Hit Control C. Go back to the WAD folder on the SD card. Paste it there. And lastly, I almost forgot. Let's go to downloads. Super Smash Bros. Brawl.bin. Now you see that it's just the save file itself, right? So what we need to do is go to the SD card, create a new folder. Control Shift N called private. And inside that one, I just hit enter. Control Shift N. Wii. Enter again. Control Shift N. Title. Enter again. And in the title folder, Control Shift N, I want RSBE, which is the four letter code for Smash Bros. Brawl NTSC version. Let's go back to the downloads folder. We'll copy this save file that we've downloaded. Go back to the SD card in private. Wii title RSBE. Paste that there. And I'll rename this to data.bin. Okay. So just a quick review then. In the SD card, in the WADS folder, I have Save Game Manager GX forwarder, Wii Mod Lite forwarder. In the apps, I needed Wii Mod Lite and Save Game Manager GX. And then under a folder called private, Wii title RSBE, we have a file called data.bin, which is the save file that we downloaded online. This file path is important, otherwise the Wii won't be able to recognize it, and neither will Save Game Manager GX. So let's head to the Wii now. So over on the Wii with the SD card inserted, let's go into the homebrew channel. Right, and this is for a Wii that we freshly modded. So let's go into Wii Mod Lite. Right, we're in. I'll press down on the D-pad to go to WAD Manager. Select Source Device SD Card. I'll go ahead and hit plus to mark both of these WADs for installation, and then hit A to proceed, A again. Okay, very good. I'll press B to back out, and I'll press the home key to exit. Now we'll look at the channel forwarder in a second, but while we're here, let's go into USB Loader GX. By the way, if you want to turn off the menu rumble, it's actually under features. I don't know why that's featured, but whatever. Okay, I'll open Super Smash Bros. Now I need it to create a save file on the Wii, right? It needs to initialize a save file on the Wii so that I have something to overwrite. Create a new save file for Super Smash Bros. Brawl, yes. Okay, so that's done. That's all I needed from starting the game. Go back out to the Wii menu. Right, so we've got our channel forwarders for Wii Mod Lite installed, and here's the one for SaveGame Manager GX. Let's go in there. So now that I'm in SaveGame Manager GX, you see the files that we have on the SD card. I'll go over to look at the Wii, and you see that I've also got the initialized Smash Bros. Brawl save file, right? RSBE, that matches. I'll go back over to the SD card. Let's go into private, Wii, title, RSBE, Smash Bros. Brawl. It is able to recognize that in this app. Now, I'll just mention, before we overwrite this save file, we're gonna lose anything that we've, any progress that we've made so far, and that includes your controller layouts. So if you haven't done it already, go take a photo of those controller layouts if you don't happen to remember them by heart, because you are going to lose them. We're about to overwrite that save file. I'll click on it and hit install. Okay. Successfully installed, very good. If you had not initialized the save file onto the Wii, then it would have given you a warning here and you would not have been able to install it. So hit okay, close that, and we'll go back out to the homebrew channel. Okay, let's go into USB Loader GX. Open Smash Bros. Brawl. So go into group, brawl, and here you see we've got everybody unlocked. So congrats, because I think it's quite a slog to unlock these yourself if you actually play through the game. I definitely decided to skip it. So that's it. That's all I wanted to show you. And yeah, I thank you for watching.